Hi, Hal. Again, this is Murugan Pattusamy. Today, I'm going to discuss the concept of serial multiple mediation model. Key agenda for the today's presentation is what is serial multiple mediation model. We'll have a small discussion about what is serial multiple mediation model, and then I'll show you an example three-path mediation model from the published literature. Then, example, we'll also do some analysis using process macro. Okay, what is simple mediation? In simple mediation, if you see this diagram, X is affecting Y through M. So here we have only one mediator between X and Y. So this model is ultimately representing the simple mediation. But if you see this diagram, here X is affecting Y through M1 and M2. Here M1 and M2 are serially mediating the relationship between X and Y. Here our ultimate goal is understanding the underlying mechanism between this X and Y, how X is affecting Y through M1 and M2, whether this M1 and M2 are serially transmitting the effect of X and Y or not. This is what our goal. But if you see this diagram, this model is representing the multiple mediation model. So here our goal is, we have a mediators called M1 and M2 between X and Y. Here our goal is finding the strength of the relationship between x and y through M1 and M2 in parallel. Whether M1 is strongly mediating the relationship between X and Y or M2 is strongly mediating the relationship between X and Y. This is what our aim here, which means we are trying to assess the strength of the mediator or strength of the two mediators used in this model. So similarly, we can also add M3, M4, M5, M6 and so on. Similarly, here we can also add M3, M4, M5 in between X and Y. But giving theoretical support for the three-path mediation model is very, very difficult. You just imagine about the four-path mediation model and five-path mediation model. So this is a simple example diagram which was taken from this particular reference. This was the book authored by Professor Hayes from Ohio State University in the year of 2013. So here X is an antecedent and Y is an outcome. So M1 and M2 are acting as a serial mediators. So this X is affecting Y through M1 and M2. This A1, A2, D21, B1, B2 are nothing but coefficient values. Here our ultimate focus is how X is affecting Y through M1 and M2. So here totally we have three paths between X and Y, that is path 1, A1, and this one is path 2, and this one is path 3. Because of that reason only, we are calling this particular model as three-path mediation model, or two mediators in serial, or in simple sense, serial mediation or serial multiple mediation. Again, the same thing, three-path mediation model. This one is four-path mediation model. So here you have X and Y, this is what antecedent and this is what outcome. In between X and Y, you have mediators called M1, M2 and M3. So here you have totally four paths, that is between X and M, you have one, and between M1 and M2, you have second path, and between M2 and M3, we have third path, and between M3 and Y, we have fourth path. So because of that reason only, this particular model is called as four-path mediation model. And you have extension to 4-path as well as 3-path mediation model, that is 5-path mediation. So here you have X as well as Y, the same antecedent and outcome. But between X and Y, you have mediators called M1, M2, M3 and M4. So path 1, path 2, path 3 and path 4 and path 5. So totally we have 5 paths. This is an example paper which was published in the journal called Journal of Management in the year of 2010. So here the model is like how customer incivility is affecting employee incivility through job demands and emotional exertion. So this one is representing the exact three-path mediation model which was presented in this slide. So here X is nothing but customer incivility and Y is nothing but employee incivility. Then M1 is nothing but job demand and M2 is nothing but emotional exertion. So X, Y M1 and M2. So here we have three paths, like customer insensitivity to job demand path 1, job demand to emotional exertion path 2, then emotional exertion to employee insensitivity path 3. So totally we have three paths. Before interpreting the results, we just see the hypothesis which was developed in this particular paper. Based on Hayes mechanism or procedure, we will have to develop four hypotheses for testing the this particular three-path mediation effect. So first one is total effect hypothesis. So here customer insensitivity is related to employee insensitivity. So we have a hypothesis called H1, that is customer insensitivity and employee insensitivity. And H2 is representing customer insensitivity on job demand and job demand on employee insensitivity. So here this M1 is acting as a mediator between this X and Y. So job demand is mediating the relationship between customer insensitivity and employee insensitivity. So this is what hypothesis 2. Then in hypothesis 3, we have X as well as Y and M2, that is what mediator 2. So here our hypothesis, emotional exertion is mediating the relationship between customer insensitivity and employee insensitivity. Then final hypothesis, this is what we are interested in. So in final hypothesis, we are saying that job demand and emotional exertion, both the variables are serially mediating the relationship between customer insensitivity and employee insensitivity. In practical sense, customer insensitivity is influencing job demand, which in turn it influences emotional exertion. Then finally, it resulted in employee insensitivity. So this is what the four hypotheses which was developed in this particular work. And see the results part. Here they have used M plus software for testing the particular mediation effect, but they have tested the serial mediation effect using the Hayes method, Hayes approach. They have followed a Hayes citation only. So here if you see the direct effect, this is similar to any SEM result or multiple regression result. So these are the coefficient values and standardized coefficient values. Then here if you see this particular in parenthesis, they have reported the standard error values. So here this one is H2, this one is H3, this one is H3, and this one is H2, and this one is H4. So we are interested in this particular hypothesis. So in H2 we are getting significant effect. If you see the confidence interval between lower limit and upper limit, 0 is not included. So which means this particular path is significant. If you see this particular hypothesis, that is customer insensitivity and employee insensitivity through emotional exertion, here between your lower limit and upper limit, 0 is included. So which means this particular path is not significant. If you see this particular hypothesis H4, here we are getting significant effect. The indirect effect value is 0.06. normally your 3-path or 4-path mediation effect would be less than the simple mediation effect or simple mediation indirect effect. So if you compare this particular value with this, so this one is having very lower value than the simple mediation effect, that is 0.13. and if you see the confidence interval here, 0 is not included between lower limit and upper limit in both the cases, like symmetric 95% confidence interval as well as bias corrected bootstrap approach. So here they have found support for the H4, that is hypothesis 4 as well as H2 and H1. So here they are getting significant relationship between customer insensitivity and job demand. So this path coefficient is significant. Similarly, here also they are getting significant path coefficient. Here also they are getting significant path coefficient. But if you see this particular path, here they are getting insignificant path coefficient. Because of that reason only, they could not able to obtain significant indirect effect for this particular hypothesis. That is hypothesis 3, customer insensitivity and emotional exertion. Employee insensitivity through emotional exertion. So ultimately, they are getting significant effect for this particular hypothesis H4. And now I am going to perform the analysis, that is using the process macro which was developed by Professor Hayes from Ohio State University. He has published a lot of papers related to serial multiple mediation model and moderated mediation and mediated moderation. So here these are the key references which I have used for preparing this particular PPT. So before testing the serial mediation path, what you can do is you just go to this website here. Just go to Professor Hayes website. Here you can able to download the process macro for SPSS program or SAS program. Here I'm using SPSS version, so already have downloaded process macro. And if you go to analyze menu and regression, here you can able to see this one, that is process by Henry F. Hayes from www.afhayes.com. So already I have downloaded this particular process macro and installed in my, that is I have added this particular add-in in my SPSS program. So straight away I can do the analysis right now. Before that, I just want to show you a template which was published are available in the Hayes website. There is a model template for process for SPSS and SAS. This particular template contains around 76 models, I think. Yeah, 76 models. Here you can able to get varieties of moderated mediation model as well as mediated moderation model. In a forthcoming videos, I'm planning to perform simple moderated mediation analysis using the same process macro. If you see the model number, here using this particular model number you can able to test the simple mediation effect. And if you see the model 6 here, using this particular model 6 you can able to test the 3-part mediation effect. This particular model or this particular process macro can accommodate up to 4 mediators between this X and Y. Now just open my data set. Totally I have 500 samples in my data set, and I have a variable, a hypothetical variable called X and a hypothetical variable called M1, M2 and Y. So totally I have 4 variables: antecedent, outcome, mediator 1 and mediator 2. Just go to analyze, look for regression and then click process macro. Just reset everything. So here you will get a dialog box like this. So here you have a option called Y, that is your outcome, and the X, your X variable, then mediators or moderators. For serial mediation model, we will have to simultaneously include this M1 and the M2. That is, serially we will have to include M1 and M2. Don't replace this M2 and M1. Suppose first, if you are inserting this M2, means M2 will be considered as a first mediator between X and Y, then M1 could be considered as a second mediator between X and Y. So this is the correct order how you can insert the mediators in this box. Then you just drag X in independent variable box and Y in the outcome variable box. And I have to choose model number 6, because in the template the serial mediation model is coming under model 6 number. So I have to choose model number 6, and I'm going to take 5000 sample, and I want to obtain bias corrected bootstrap sample results. So click OK. So it is estimating the results. You see here you can able to get something like running matrix. Yeah, we got the results. So totally I have 500 samples. My X is, that is I'm using model number 6. Here my Y is Y and X is X, M1 is M1 and M2 is M2. Suppose if I replace this X, Y and M1, M2 with some variable name called hypothetical variable name, means here I'll be getting Y equal to something and X equal to something and M1 equal to something like that. So this one is similar to normal multiple regression analysis result. So here M1 is dependent variable and X is independent variable. So X on M1 is significant, because we are getting exactly 0.00 as a p-value. Similarly, the bootstrap confidence interval does not include 0 between its lower limit as well as upper limit. That is, lower limit confidence interval and upper limit confidence.